Hello everyone, I am Prashast Jain, Senior Mathematics Faculty in CLC Sikar. Today we are going to discuss solution of paper JEE mains held on 8th January in evening shift. Okay, let's start. Question number 1. Matrix हम लोगों को दी हुई है A और एक identity matrix हमें दी हुई है. हमसे पूछा हुआ है n times of A inverse matrix. As we know, A inverse equals to adjoint of A upon determinant of A. Determinant A here is 8 minus 18, that is minus 10. And adjoint of A will be minus 4, 2, minus 2 and minus 9. So 10 times of A inverse matrix becomes minus 4 plus 2, 9, minus 2. Now this matrix can also be written like 2, 2, 9, 4, minus 6 times of identity matrix. So the answer is A minus 6 I. That is option number 2nd. Question number 2. A vector and B vector have been given. C vector is a vector which is satisfying the equation. B vector cross C vector equals to B vector cross A vector, and C dot A is also 0. We multiply with A vector in both sides. Now we will apply vector triple product. So it is B vector dot A vector into C vector minus C vector dot A vector into B vector. Here B vector dot A vector into A vector minus A vector dot A vector into B vector. Now B dot A will be equal to 1 plus 2 plus 1, that is 4 times of C vector, minus C dot A is given as 0, equals to B dot A again is 4 times of A vector. Now A dot A is, modulus of A vector is 1 plus 4 plus 1, that is root over 6. So A dot A is 6 times of B vector. Now we know the A vector and B vector here, and C vector can be found from this. So when we put the values of A vector and B vector in this equation, we will find C vector as minus half I cap minus half J cap minus half K cap. Now C vector dot B vector will be equal to minus half plus half and minus half, that is equal to minus half. That is option number 3. Okay, question number 3rd. Sequence and progression ka question diya hua hai. 10th term hume di hui hai AP ki. To A plus 9D equals to 1 upon 20. 20th term will be A plus 19D equals to 1 upon 10. We will solve these equation and we will get A 1 upon 200 and D also 1 upon 200. Okay. Now we have to find sum of first 200 terms, which will be equal to N upon 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into t. Now this will be equal to 201 upon 2, which is equals to option number 4th. Okay. Question number fourth. Hyperbola passes through the point 10, 16 and having vertices at plus minus 6, 0. Since vertices are on x-axis and its center is 0, 0, so it is a standard hyperbola. We can assume its equation to be x square upon 36 minus y square upon b square equals to 1. Now this hyperbola passes through 10, 16, so it should satisfy this equation. 100 upon 36 minus 256 upon b square equal to 1. From here we will get b square as 144. So now we know the equation of hyperbola. Now we have to find equation of normal at point P. Now the formula for the normal will be a square x upon x1 minus b square y upon y1 equals to a square minus a square plus b square, and also here also we'll get plus. We will put the values of a and b, which will be 36 x upon 10 plus 144 y upon 16 equals to a square plus b square, which is equal to 36 plus 144, that is 180. Now it we can simplify this equation and we will get 2x plus 5y equals to 100. Okay. Question number 5. Differential equation di hui hai ek family of curves ki, aur differential equation ek family of curves ki puchi hui hai, normal equation di hui hai. So for this we have to remove the parameter b. So we will differentiate the given equation and we will get 2x equals to 4b into y dash, that is y dash equals to x upon 2b, or say b equals to x upon 2y dash. We will put the value of this b in the given equation, so we will get x square equals to x upon 2y dash into 4 into y plus x upon 2y dash. We will simplify this equation and we will get x y dash whole square equals to x plus 2y into y dash. Okay, next. Question number 6th. Area has been asked which is bounded by the region x square less than y less than equal to 3 minus 2x. Okay, so first we will draw the diagrams. Y is greater than equal to x square is actually the region which is inside this parabola, and y equals to 3 minus 2x is this straight line. So the region is this. We will solve equations y equal to x square and y equals to 3 minus 2x. When we'll solve these equations, we will get coordinates of these points of intersection as minus 3, 9 and 1, 1. So the required area will be equal to upper curve minus lower curve, that is 3 minus 2x minus x square integration over minus 3 to 1. We will solve these integration very easily and we will get 32 upon 3. Okay, next question. Question number 7th. ओरिजन से दिए गए कर्व के पॉइंट 2.2 पर जो नॉर्मल खींचा गया है उस पर परपेंडिकुलर की लेंथ पूछी गई है. सो फर्स्ट वी विल फाउंड इक्वेशन ऑफ नॉर्मल ड्रॉन एट पॉइंट 2.2. फॉर दिस वी विल डिफरेंशिएट एंड फाइंड द डेरिवेटिव वैल्यू एट 2.2. सो व्हेन वी डिफरेंशिएट द गिवन इक्वेशन वी विल गेट 2x प्लस 2y प्लस 2x into y dash minus 6y dash equals to 6y into y dash equals to 0. When we will satisfy this equation through 2.2, we will get 4 plus 4 plus 4y dash minus 12 y dash equals to 0. That is y dash equals to 1. That is slope of the tangent at 2.2 is 1. So slope of normal at 2.2 will be minus 1. So equation of normal at 2.2 will be y minus y1 equal to minus 1 into x minus x1. That is x plus y minus 4 equals to 0. So now the required length is length of the normal drawn from origin to this line. That will be equal to the required distance d equals to 4 upon root 2. That is 2 root 2. Okay, next. Question number 8th. A system of linear equation has been given and the solutions, about the solution we have been asked. So first of all, we will find value of the determinant D. That will be equal to lambda 2 lambda 3, 5, 4, lambda and 6. We will solve it and factorize it. We will get minus times of lambda plus 8 into lambda minus 8. Okay. Now we will solve determinant D1, which will be equal to 5, 8, 10, 2, 3, lambda, 2, 5, 6. When we will solve this determinant, we will get 34 minus 9 lambda. Now, if we observe the options, we are clearly observing when lambda equals to 2, d becomes 0, but d1 do not become 0. If d equals to 0 and d1 is not 0, then there cannot be any solution. So, option number 2 is correct. Okay. Question number 9th. Y equal to mx plus c is tangent to a circle and it is also perpendicular to the line L1, where L1 is tangent to this circle at the point 1 by root 2 comma 1 by root 2. Now, if we find equation of tangent of this circle at 1 by root 2 comma 1 by root 2, it will be equal to x into 1 by root 2 plus y into 1 by root 2 equals to 1. Slope of this line is minus 1 and the required tangent is perpendicular to L1. If its slope is minus 1, then slope of that line will be plus 1. That is m equals to plus 1. Now, we can write this equation as x minus y plus c equals to 0. Now, this straight line is tangent to the circle x minus 3 whole square plus y square equal to 1. So, the length of the perpendicular dropped from its center will be equal to the radius of the circle. That is, 3 comma 0 se agar hum ispe perpendicular dalenge, to wo us circle ki radius ke barabar hoga. तो 3.0 से हमने इस सर्किल पर एक परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉप किया जिसकी लेंथ ये होगी. ये गिवन सर्किल के रेडियस के बराबर होगा यानी कि 1 के बराबर होगा. नाउ इफ वी टेक स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन वी विल गेट सी स्क्वायर plus 9 plus 6 times of C equals to 2. So the equation reduces to C square plus 6C plus 7 equals to 0, which is option number first. Okay. Next question. Question number 10th. A function, a set of functions has been given which should be continuous on 0 to 1 and differentiable on open 0 to open 1. Now we have to find the correct option. The answer has been given in the official answer key as option number 3rd, but according to us this question is wrong, as all four options can be proved wrong if we take function as a constant function. Okay, I will show to you every option. Take function fx equals to 0 for all 0 to 1, that is fx equals to 0. We have taken fx as 0. Now fc is 0, f1 is 0, so left hand side of the option number first is 0, and the right hand side, as function is constant, f dash c also 0, so this is 0 less than 0, which is incorrect option. So option number 1 is not correct for all the function, so it is wrong. Similarly, if we take any constant function and check option number 2, f1 and fc will be equal to, so left hand side is 0 and f dash c is also 0, but it is true for constant function. If we check through LMVT option number 2, then left hand side will be equal to f1 minus fc upon 1 minus c, which is equal to f dash some another point. That is at c, f dash c is not equal to this option. So this option is also incorrect. If we check option number 3rd, if fx is equals to a constant function, again left hand side is 0 and right hand side is 0, 0 less than 0, which is incorrect. Again, this left hand side is 0 for a constant function and right hand side is also 0, so 0 less than 0. So option number 4th is also incorrect. That is, all options are incorrect. That is, according to us, this question is wrong. Okay, next. Ek point ki, ek plane ke about mirror image di hui hai, aur options de rakhe hame ki kaun sa point us plane par lie karta hai. So the line joining 1, 2, 3 and this point will be perpendicular to the plane. From there we can find direction ratios of the normal. Direction ratios of normal will be 1 plus 7 by 3, that is 10 by 3, comma 2 plus 4 by 3, that is 10 by 3, that 3 plus 1 by 3, that is again 10 by 3. So direction ratios are proportional, so we can take this as 1, 1 and 1 also. Now the middle point of these two points will be lie on plane. Midpoint of these two points will be 1 minus 7 upon 3 divided by 2, that is minus 4 by 3 upon 2, comma 2 minus 4 by 3, that is 2 by 3 upon 2, comma 3 minus 1 by 3, 8 upon 3 upon 2. That is, middle point is minus 2 by 3, comma 1 by 3, comma 4 by 3. This point lies on the plane and the direction ratios of the normal are 1, 1, 1. So the equation of required plane will be 1 into x plus 2 by 3 plus 1 into y minus 1 by 3 plus 1 into y z minus 4 by 3 equals to 0. That is, this equation becomes x plus y plus z minus 1 equals to 0. By observing, we can say that 1 comma minus 1 comma 1, that is option number first, satisfies this equation. So option number 1 is correct. Okay, next. Question number 12th. A very simple question of limit has been asked, which can be solved using L'Hopital rule. So since it is a format of 0 upon 0, we can directly apply L'Hopital rule. That is, we will differentiate in numerator and in denominator. In denominator, the derivative is 1. To differentiate the numerator, we will apply Leibniz rule. That is, x into sine 10 x. As this limit is very clearly observed, 0. Question number 14th. Let A and B are two events such that probability that exactly one of them occurs is 2 by 5 and the probability that A or B occurs is 1 by 2. Exactly one of them occurs, we can write this probability by probability A union B minus probability A intersection B. It is 2 upon 5. Now probability A or B occurs is represented by probability A union B, which is given as 1 by 2. We will put the value of probability A union B as 1 by 2 in equation number first, and through calculation we can easily find that probability A intersection B equals to 1 upon 10, that is 0.1. Okay. Next question. Question number 15th. A integral has been given and we have to find between which two values I square will lie. So for this, let fx equals to 2x cube minus 9x square plus 12x plus 4. Through its derivative, we will find that whether this function is increasing or decreasing in interval 1 to 2. If we differentiate this, we will get 6x square minus 18x plus 12. We take 6 as common, we'll get x square minus 3x plus 2, that is x minus 1 into x minus 2. Now between the interval 1 to 2, this f dash x is negative, so fx is decreasing in interval 1 to 2. So we can say that fx is less than f of 1 and greater than f of 2 for all x in interval 1 to 2. F2 we can find, it will get 8, and F1, if you calculate F1, then it will be 9. So fx lies between 8 and 9 in this interval. Now 1 upon root fx will be lying between 1 upon 2 root 2 and 1 upon 3. Now, if we integrate both sides, all the sides in the interval 1 to 2, then we will get 1 upon 2 root 2. Integration of 1 upon 2 root 2 from 1 to 2 will be 1 upon 2 root 2. Integration of this element is I. And 1 upon 3 ko agar hum integrate karta hai 1 se 2 mein, to we will get 1 upon 3. So we can say that I square will be between 1 upon 9 to 1 upon 8. That is option number first. Okay. Question number 16th. Number of roots has to be asked in this equation. So for this, we'll take critical point of these two modulus. As we know, 3 to the power x becomes 1 when x equals to 0, and 3 to the power x becomes 2 when x equals to log 2 base 3. So here we goes in three cases. Case number first, x belongs to minus infinity to 0. 3 to the power x into 3 to the power x minus 1 plus 2 equals to 1 minus 3 to the power x plus 2 minus 3 to the power x. this equations becomes 3 to the power x whole square plus 3 to the power x minus 1 equals to 0. So 3 to the power x equals to minus 1 plus minus 1 minus of minus 4, that is 5, divided by 2a. Now 3 to the power x equals to minus 1 plus root 5 divided by 2 is a positive number, and in minus infinity to 0 it is also possible. So minus 1 plus root 5 upon 2 is the correct option, but 3 to the power x can not be negative. So minus 1 minus root 5 upon 2 is not possible. So here we are getting only one real root of x, that is log root 5 minus 1 divided by 2 base 3. So in this case we are getting only one real root. Second case, in second case we will take x in interval 0 to log 2 by 3. So this equation becomes 3 to the power x into 3 to the power x minus 1 plus 2 equals to 3 to the power x minus 1 plus 2 minus 3 to the power x. So this equation is 3 to the power x whole square minus 3 to the power x plus 1 equals to 0. 3 to the power x equals to 1 plus minus 1 minus 4, that is minus 3, divided by 2a. It is not real number, so here in this case we are not getting any real root. So now we move on case number third. In case number third, we are going to take x in the interval log 2 by 3 to infinity. In this case, equation becomes 3 to the power x into 3 to the power x minus 1 plus 2 equals to 3 to the power x minus 1 plus 3 to the power x minus 2. Now this equation becomes 3 to the power x whole square minus 3 into 3 to the power x plus 5 equals to 0. Now 3 to the power x equals to 3 plus minus root over 9 minus 20 divided by 2a. Again it is not a real number, so again in this case also we are not getting any real number. So finally we can say that we are having only one real root of this equation. Okay, so S will have only one element, that is S is a singleton set. Okay, next question. Question number 17. Alpha has been given, A and B both are expressed in terms of alpha. Now we have to find equation whose roots are A and B. So for this we can easily say that here alpha is omega, where omega is imaginary cube root of unity. Now we will solve for A. A is 1 plus alpha into 1 plus alpha square plus alpha to the power 4 and so on up to alpha to the power 200. We'll put alpha as omega. It is 1 plus omega. Now this is a geometric progression having 101 terms. So applying formula of GP, 1 minus alpha square to the power 101 upon 1 minus alpha square. It is 1 plus omega. Alpha is omega, and we are getting here omega to the power 202. omega to the power 202 is equal to omega. 1 minus alpha square is also omega square. So in numerator also we are getting 1 minus omega square, in denominator also. So this is 1. So value of A is 1. Now we will proceed at B. B is 1 plus alpha cube plus alpha to the power 6 and so on up to alpha to the power 300. As alpha is omega, so alpha cube, alpha to the power 6 and all these terms will be equal to 1. So this becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to 101 terms. So it is equal to 101. So now we are having A as 1 and B as 101. So the required quadratic equation will be x square minus a plus b, that is 102x, plus a into b, that is 101, equals to 0. That is option number 4 is correct. Question number 19th. Alpha and beta are coefficients of x to the power 4 and x square in this given expansion. So first we will simplify this expansion. This expansion will be equal to 2 times of x to the power 6 plus 6c2 x to the power 4 into x square minus 1 plus 6c4 x square into x square minus 1 whole square plus 6c6 x square minus 1 power 3. Okay. We will simplify further. 2 x to the power 6 plus 15 x to the power 4 into x square minus 1 plus 15 x square x to the power 4 minus 2x square plus 1 plus x to the power 6 minus 3x to the power 4 plus 3x square minus 1. Now we will find alpha and beta. Alpha is coefficient of x to the power 4. So it will be equal to 2 times of minus 15 minus 30 and minus 3, and we will simplify this and we will get minus 96. Now beta is coefficient of x square, so it will be equal to 2 times of 15 plus 3, that is 36. Now alpha minus beta equals to minus 96 minus 36, that is minus 132. Okay, option number 2. Question number 20. A function has been given which is defined over the interval 1, 2, 3. We have to find the range of this function. Now we will break this function in two intervals. When we take x belongs to 1 to 2, then this function becomes x upon 1 plus x square. When we take x belonging to 2 to 3, this function becomes 2x upon 1 plus x square. Now if we differentiate this function in interval 1 to 2, we will get f dash x as 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square whole square, which is negative in 1 to 2. That is f dash x is negative, so function fx is decreasing in 1 to 2. Similarly, this function is also decreasing in interval 2 to 3. So in interval 1 to 2 we will find separately its range, and in 2 to 3 also we will find its possible values. Now fx belongs to If we find its value at 1, it is 1 upon 2. At 0.2, its value is 2 upon 5. In 1 to 2. If we take x belonging to 2, 2, 3, at x equals to 2, its value is 4 upon 5. At x equal to 3, its value is 6 upon 10, that is 3 by 5. So, we can say, if x belongs to 1, 2, 3, then this function will belong from 2 by 5 to 1 by 2 union 3 by 5 to 4 by 5. Option number 3 is correct. Question number 21. Sum has been asked. So, it is a very simple question. 1 upon 4. We just multiplied this expression n equal to 1. To 7 n square plus n multiplied by 2n plus 1. It is equal to 1 by 4 2n cube plus 3n square plus n. Now this is equal to 1 upon 4. We will apply the formulas of sigma n cube and take n as 7. So, it is 2 n into n plus 1 upon 2 whole square plus 3 n into n plus 1 into 2 n plus 1 upon 6 plus sigma of n is n into n plus 1 upon 2. When we will simplify this expression, we will get 504. Okay. Next question. Question number 22. A straight line y equal to mx intersect the parabola y square equal to x at a point P other than the origin and tangent to it at P meet the x axis at the point Q. Parabola or a straight line de rakhe hain, jo origin ke alawa point P par cut karte hain. Point P par khichi gai tangent x axis ko Q par cut karti hai. Triangle OPQ ka area hume de rakha hai. M ki value hum logo se puchi gai hai. So, let's start with the diagram. This is point P. This is a straight line y equal to mx. This is origin. This is tangent at point P. It is Q. Let's assume point P is A T square comma 2 A T. Tangent at point P, that is PQ, will be TY equal to X plus A T square. If we put Y equals to 0 in this equation, we'll get coordinates of point Q. So, coordinates of point Q is minus 1 by 4 t square comma 0. Now, area of this triangle will be 1 by 2 OQ, that is 1 by 4 t square into length of normal dropped from P to the x axis, that is 1 by 2 t, and this is equals to 4 square units, that is t cube equals to 64. So, t equals to 4. So, point P becomes 4 comma 2. Now, this point will satisfy equation y equal to mx. So, 2 equals to 4m. So, m equals to 0.5. Okay. Question number 23. root 2 sine alpha upon 1 plus cos 2 alpha modulus equal to 1 by 7. This is root 2 sine alpha upon root 2 cos alpha equal to 1 by 7. That is tan alpha equals to 1 by 7. Now, this is 2 sin square beta upon 2, that is sin square beta modulus. Sin beta is 1 by root 10. So, tan beta equals to 1 by 3. Now, tan 2 beta equals to 2 tan beta upon 1 minus tan square beta, that is 3 upon 4. Now, tan alpha plus 2 beta equals to tan alpha plus tan 2 beta upon 1 minus tan alpha into tan 2 beta. After solving this, we will get this as 1. Okay. Question number 24. Fx is a polynomial, a lot of information has been given and we have to find local minima point of fx. So, as f dash x is a critical point at x equal to 1, that is f double dash x will become 0 at x equal to 1. So, we start with f double dash x, let f double dash x equals to lambda times x minus 1. Now, we integrate this thing, f dash x equals to lambda x square by 2 minus lambda x plus constant of integration c. Now, since we know that f x has a critical point at x equals to minus 1, that is f dash minus 1 equals to 0. When we will apply this thing, we will get c equals to minus 3 lambda upon 2. That is f dash x equals to lambda x square upon 2 minus lambda x minus 3 lambda by 2. Again, we will integrate this thing, or we can use also that f of minus 1 equals to 10 and f of 1 equal to minus 6. For to use the those things, we will integrate fx. Fx integral is lambda into x minus lambda x square by 2 minus 3 lambda by 2 x plus constant of integration in c. We will apply the data as f of minus 1 equals to 10 and f of 1 equal to minus 6 in these, in the function of fx. Now, if we put these data in f dash x, we will get f dash x as 3x square minus 6x minus 9. That is 3 times x square minus 2x minus 3, that is x minus 3 into x plus 1. So, at x equals to 3, derivative will change from minus 2 plus. So, x equals to 3 is minima point of fx. Okay. Next question. Question number 25. A word examination has been given and we have to find number of 4 lettered words which can be formed using these letters. So, first we will write letters, number of letters in this word. E is used 1 times, X is used 1 time, A is used 2 times, M is used 1 time, I is used 2 times, N is used 2 times, T is used 1 time, O is used again for one time. So these are total 11 letters. Okay. Now we will first form category, then we will select, and then we will arrange. So first we will find those words in which all four letters are different. Four different letters like E, X, A, M. So we are having total 8 letters. We will select 4 letters out of these 8 letters, like in 8C 4 ways, and every selection can be arranged in factorial 4 ways. So these types of word will be 8C 4 into factorial 4. Second type will be 2 different and 2 alike letters like A, A, M, I. So for this we will first select alike letters. Those are available A, I and N. So from this, these three letters we will decide first letter, one letter, 3C1, and remaining two letters can be selected from any remaining letter, that is 7C2. Now every word can be arranged in factorial 4 by factorial 2 ways. So there will be total 3C1 into 7C2 into factorial 4 upon 2 number of words of this pattern. Third pattern will be 2 alike plus 2 alike like A, A, I, I. So two letters are available, only A, I and N. So we will select two letters from this. Now every letters, every selection of these letters can be arranged in factorial 4 upon factorial 2, factorial 2 ways. Now we will calculate all these things, and when we will sum it, we will find answer as 2454. Okay, thank you. It's all.